Holidays or not, everyone in our house is always pretty hectic with sports, shopping, or even homework. So for dinner, I like to change the pace and make lovely spicy slow-cooked dishes. And one of my family's favorites is brilliantly spicy braised oxtail stew with a radish salad, followed by chili poached pears. And when my mum's around, trust me, I love getting her in the kitchen.
Now, oxtail was something that we grew up with.
Yep. It's something you do in the morning and put it in the oven because it has to be cooked really, really slow, yes.
I'm going to dust this in flour. It's amazing how I used to make it stretch for like 5 or 6 dinners.
Oh, don't exaggerate. It's not that bad.
Now I know why we're all so skinny growing up.
It wasn't that bad.
I'm joking. Come on. You know I'm joking.
But you see, sometimes we went to the butcher's and you had maybe extra 2 or 3. Mm-hmm. I used to put it in a saucepan and you had lovely stock for soup.
Scots broth, I remember. Now, we'll peel a couple of cloves of garlic. I'll show you a quick way of getting that out. Get your knife and just mash it.
A mess.
No, it's not a mess. Right, oxtail in. I'm going to fry that off. Okay, and get that nice and brown. And we've all braised it in red wine and sort of chicken stock before, but I'm going to get this done with a Chinese influence. You started cooking at home quite early on, right?
17 and a half.
17 and a half. Your mum died quite young.
Very young, 26.
26. So who taught you how to cook?
Nobody taught you. I think you just learn as you get older.
And did you enjoy it?
Yes, I did enjoy it, yeah. That is a nice vegetable, that.
The fennel?
Fennel, isn't it?
Isn't that lovely?
It's beautiful, yeah.
You just slice that up, Mum. Now, these are nice and brown.
Okay. They look lovely. Yeah.
Put the colour on there. You just slice up the chilli, OK? Just slice it down. I'm going to keep the seeds in there because I want some heat as well.
That's that anise thing.
Star anise, that's right.
Yeah. I like ginger, do you?
I love ginger, especially fresh.
Yeah.
Coriander seeds, a little handful. In.
Yeah.
And soy sauce. That helps give it that saltiness and a nice dark, rich colour on the vegetables. So as it braises, the meat tenderises quicker.
I would never do anything fennel and the chilies and that, but it smells lovely.
Does that smell nice?
Mm-hmm.
And then a little bit of this. This is a...
What's that?
A rice wine vinegar.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Some oxtail back on top of the vegetables.
Yeah.
Gonna top that up.
Is that beef stock, yeah?
This
or
is
vegetable stock?
No, a really nice chicken stock.
Why are you putting chicken stock in with it?
Because oxtail itself is quite rich.
Yeah.
Chicken stock's nice and light. Just cover it with stock.
Lovely colour, isn't it?
It's a beautiful colour. Oh. Little taste. Here we go. Big deep breath. OK, Nan?
Well, that's lovely. I can taste the fennel in that.
Is that nice?
That's lovely.
What? Oh, Jesus. Damn. Water for Nan. Come on. Take some water, Nanny.
It's not water, that's
it is. Water, come on. While Mum recovers from the kick of the chilli, to go with my oriental-influenced oxtail, I'm going to knock up a quick, fresh radish salad. Take a bunch of radishes and separate off the edible leaves. Once washed thoroughly, place half the radishes in the bowl with the leaves. Chop the remaining radishes in half and add them too. Next, peel and finely slice a banana shallot. Add them to the radishes and season with salt and pepper. Dress with a good squeeze of fresh lemon juice and a drizzle of olive oil. Then mix. Radish salad, it's that simple. Next up, dessert.
Delicious poached pears.
I love pears.
Ready? Yeah. So we're going to poach them with a little bit of chilli.
Chilli? Never heard of that.
A little
before.
Bit of saffron. No?
No.
Now, pan on. Take off a little slice like that so they stand up nicely. And then peel.
Okay, then.
And then the chilli, you hold that up and just go down.
Yeah.
Through. And open that up, okay? Into the water. Seeds in as well.
Seeds in as well.
Hello,
oh, hello, Holes.
Hi, Holes.
What is that smell? It smells so good.
You've got the most amazing oxtail in there. Hello, mate. Mm. You well?
Yeah, good thing.
Hello, mate.
Hi,
Dad.
How was your day? So, what were you making there?
So, we're going to poach these pears, a little bit of chilli, water, and sugar. What are they, Holes?
Mm.
It's exactly that. Saffron is expensive, but you only need the tiniest little bit.
A little pinch to make that water go light and golden. We're going to make the most amazing
Star anise dust.
Star anise dust?
Dust. You get your star anise in there, seed up, and then you start grinding. A little teaspoon of ginger. Give it a nice mix. Thank you, mate. And that's going to dust the top of the pears once they're cooked. Right, get your pears. Drop them in there. And that's what we're going to sprinkle. Ginger and star anise. Once they're cooked, cool down, sprinkle that over the top. Right, have you guys got homework?
Yes.
See you guys
come
later.
Come back shortly.
See
thank you.
Later.
Love you, Dad. Love you, Nana.
Love you, too. Bye. Turn that down and let them boil. OK.
Bye.
Thank you, guys.
Bye.
After an 8-minute simmer, our pears should be ready.
Now, just get your knife, Mum, and put the knife through and see how easy the knife is. So that means they're soft and cooked. Now, you can leave them in there overnight, 2 or 3 days.
All right.
And they just get darker and more beautiful. I mean, they look impressive.
They smell delicious, don't they?
Don't they?
Look at the colours now. It's lovely, isn't it? The
colours are amazing, man. And then take your little star anise dust and just dust over.
Oh, look at that. It's lovely.
Now for my favourite part. The oxtail. Wow. That is beautiful.
It just melts in your mouth, doesn't it?
I love the way you see that just all sliding down the bone. If you can, up to the table, please, Nan.
Oh, yes, I will do.
Lovely. And I will grab that. That is beautiful.
This is my ultimate thrifty dinner. Sumptuous, slow-cooked Chinese braised oxtail with a light and peppery radish salad, followed by gorgeous chili poached pears with star anise dust.
Jack, Holly, Tilly, Megan, hi. Look at this. Time to see what you think.
It's delicious.
Good, nice. Mum, what do you think?
It's lovely.
Is it?
Puts me in mind of days gone by. A lot of people just lift it up and eat it with their hands.
No. Has anyone saved room for those delicious, stunning pears?
We have.
I have.
I have.
Nanny, good to see you. Super Nan.
Cheers.
Nice.
Cheers.